She's the radio host turned YouTube sensation who can't read analog clocks and was once a stilt walker. But Tanya Hennessy shot to fame with her realistic makeup tutorial video. Take a look.
Okay, so my everyday makeup routine generally starts with a primer. I use this MAC primer that a lady sold me against my will. And then once I've done priming my face, which I don't actually know what it does or what it is, but it was very expensive, so I continue to use it, I use either this Maybelline Fit Me product that I bought from Kohl's for $10.49, or I use this MAC Studio Fix Fluid, depending whether or not I'm tan. I don't know what I'm doing.
And she's with us at the panel for us this morning. Tanya, welcome to Studio 10.
I'm stoked to be here. Oh, I've watched the show. I'm on the show.
I love that video because it is so true. Like, you know, we have our faces magically painted by people downstairs who make us look like completely different people. But I loved how real that video was. 300,000 hits.
300 million.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah. 300 million. Yeah. That's a lot of views.
Yeah, and it's like completely shocking to me. I made it in like a backyard or like my dodgy room in Canberra one afternoon at 6 o'clock at night. I uploaded, I edited it straight away, put it up 10 o'clock at night. I woke up the next morning with, I think, 450,000 followers.
Oh my God.
I was on
God.
Teen Vogue.
Wow.
I mean, for a chubby girl to be on Teen Vogue, I was living my life.
You are Rubenesque.
Yeah, yes, like I just went crazy and I'm still genuinely in shock. I can't believe like I'm on this TV program from that crazy video I did.
You're in shock. You're 1,000 times more famous than I thought you were.
And before you, so you're a radio host. That's your job.
Yeah.
And before that, you were literally a stilt walker, and you fell on someone quite famous.
Ridiculous.
Could you give us a name?
Yeah, I worked at Luna Park in Sydney. And this is the ones with the, you sort of walk like an animal. That was so friggin' hard. I can barely walk on two legs, let alone four. And also, walking on two legs that are 3 feet tall is incredibly difficult.
Yeah.
That was years and years ago. But the first time I came out into the park, because you've got to learn to walk on the asphalt, walk on the different surfaces, I walked out and I tripped on the stilts and I went like this and just grabbed someone's head because that's, you know, the right, I guess, measure. And it was Russell Crowe.
Wow. Wow. What are you saying?
And I was like, I'm so sorry. And he was like, nah.
Did he unleash hell?
I can't obviously remember I'm making that, but he wasn't pleased.
Can I ask, was it in his, because he's always sort of changing the way he looks for various roles, was it in his kind of the insider kind of moment? Because that would have broken your fall quite easily. But if it was in his gladiator sort of prep, that would have been quite a hard landing.
You know, I don't even remember. I just remember him wearing the Rabbitohs jumper and then seeing his face and being like, Russell Crowe!
Oh, was it an accident or was it kind of sort of accidentally on purpose?
That's right. Did you have to actually walk 500 metres to get to Russell Crowe before?
I'm genuinely terrible at the stilts. Thank God I don't do that anymore.
So how did you go from falling all over Russell Crowe to being in radio?
You know, I was working as a dresser as well. I'm like a jack of all trades, master of literally zero. I was working a dresser on Mary Poppins, like literally putting clothes on performers.
Oh, wow.
I know, it's such a weird gig. And, you know, when you want to be on the stage, it's quite torturous putting clothes, you know, on people. And one of the girls in the ensemble of Mary Poppins said, Tanya, you should do radio. And at the time I was doing a bit of stand-up and I wasn't really getting a lot of joy from it because it's so singular, whereas working with two people, I felt like bounce, this would be fun. And then I volunteered when I was 26 for a really, really, really long time. And 5 years later, I'm doing a national show. So it's like really great.
Yeah.
And I'm stoked.
Hello. And now you've become a life guru with your book.
Oh.
Yes.
It's like how to fail successfully. It's like the things not to do.
There it is. Am I doing this right? Do you have a number one life tip?
Yes, be yourself fearlessly and relentlessly. That is like the best tip ever. Like I feel like for such a long time I wanted to be an actor and a stilt worker and all these things. Right. And the minute I stopped trying to be somebody else by wearing a facade as being an actor and I started to be myself, everything worked for me. So my biggest advice to everyone is to be themselves authentically. Yeah.
And if you can't do that, fall on Russell Crowe.
Yeah, or be Beyonce.
Now, make sure you grab your get your hands on Tanya's book. It is out now. Tanya, you'll have to come and guest host the show one day.
Yes.
Oh. I would die
All right, we'll have our people talk to your people.
Yeah. But, please, I would
yeah,
love
if you've got
that.
A spare 3.5 hours, we'd love to see you again.
Girl. Do I? I do swing to nothing. I make videos online. Oh, yeah, I'm free.
That's right. She's got nothing on for the next 20 years.
Literally.
Tanya, Hennessy, everyone.